Ladies and gentlemen, my topic is study on the stereoscopic codecs for non-real-time 3D TV services. Here is the background. Currently, as you know, 3D and 3D TV is gaining momentum around the world, particularly in the movie and TV industry. Actually, terrestrial and satellite and cable operators are seeing the migration from the conventional 2D to 3D. And currently, frame-compatible 3D services are launched in somewhere like in United States, UK, Sky, and Japan, even in Korea. In Korea, satellite operator is delivering frame-compatible 3D services, and cable is doing some 3D BOD services, while terrestrial is experimenting their service-compatible 3D services using hybrid codec. We are considering the impact video and H.264 AVC. Also, they are seeing another delivery, which is NLT, which is newly drafted in ATSC. Why? Because of the bandwidth for 3D, because particularly in ATSC, the bandwidth is 19 megabps, but in order to deliver 3D video, yeah, we think about this kind of trial. The lab video with impact video with 12 megabps, while the 6 megabps for ABC. So NLT might be an alternative solution. So in this paper, in our study, we'd like to, find a solution to deliver 3D content over DTV networks with non-real-time manner. So the focus area of this paper is the stereoscopic codec for NLT 3D service. Especially, we elaborate on the experiment to find out the optimal codec for our ATSC. Approaches are independent and interview. As a preliminary study, we also made a definition of some NLT scenario and some sort of a requirement and consideration. Here is some concept of stereoscopic NLT. NLT is an alternative way to deliver non-streaming content. Yeah, it's like on a file on a directory object in the data channel. The basic concept is the advanced delivery of the designated NLT stereoscopic content in a careful manner. Here's some concept diagram. This path is the NLT. Actually, while this path is the 3D real-time video. And actually, this path could either broadcast, either a telco network, even a USB from the user. And if you take a look at the receiver side, then this receiver provider enough storage for the NLT content, even some sort of synchronized mechanism, because in some scenario, the lab video can be delivered in this real-time channel, while the enhancement layer video, for example, the write video, can be delivered in this channel in advance. According to the NLT protocol. Here is some NLT scenario. In ATSC, they are targeting this kind of scenario. The typical application for NLT services include push video, news, information, and weather services, and even the personalized DTV channel, music distribution, and also the reference information on a wide range of topics. But I think they are targeting a little bit the short-form clip, not long-form clip. But in the case of 3D, we have to think about this kind of forms, short-form and long-form, because if you want to deliver the HD 3D clip, yeah, it's going to be long-form, or the size might be huge. Yeah, and so right. If you consider the delivery, we can have two scenarios, in-package delivery and out-of-package delivery. In-package delivery implies that both left and right videos are packed into a one single file and deliver in an RT channel. And this out of packet delivery means that the left and right videos are separated. For example, the left videos are delivered in a real-time channel while the additional video, I mean a right video, is delivered after being packetized into a file. So in our study, we targeted mainly this scenario. And here's some considerations and requirements. We thought about this requirement and consideration. First one is the compatibility. It's very essential requirement, I think. So it would be very useful if the NLT or some sort of new things can provide it the backward compatibility, because most people want a 2D, even from a 3D content. And next one is the coding performance. Yeah, if we use the more high-performance codec, we can reduce a lot of bandwidth. And then latency delay, for example, if you use the MPEG-2 and ABC, there might be some end-to-end delay. So we expect that the minimization of the latency delay. And another issue is the synchronization. Yes. For example, if we use the MPEG-2 and ABC, the GOP size might be different. Then we have to consider the synchronization. Also, when you see the terminal side, if two videos are separately delivered, this synchronization can be a critical issue. And also, the last consideration might be the complexity in the coding step, also the receiver component. Okay. Again, our paper is mainly focused on the evaluation of the possible codec with these two approaches, independent and interview. Actually, we skipped this MPEG-2 plus MPEG-2 because the quality and actually it's impossible to deliver in ATSC DTV channel. And here in the case of interview coding, we skip this MVP and HBC. So we mainly focus on MPEG-2 plus ABC, and MPEG-2 plus HBC is currently developed in MPEG. And then also in the case of interview, MPEG-2 and ABC, also MBC. This figure shows the coding structure. The first one is the independent, like it is simulcast. And the second one is the MVP, a basic diagram of MBC. MBC, with this following test sequences. We've tested with a reference software for MPEG-2. We used the MPEG-2 simulation software group version 12. And in the case of ABC, we used the JM 17.1. And here is the test condition or configuration. GOP size is 24, main profile high, and then a target bit rate is 12 and 7 megabps. Actually, 12 megabps currently in our terrestrial 3D trial, yet we use this 12 megabps. So we evaluate this 12 megabps as well as this 17 megabps. And for ABC, we use this configuration. When it comes to the GOP size, entropy period in 24 in order to align with the impact 2. For HBC, we used the TMOC, this software, GOP24, and with this coding tool. When we simulate, we've got this PSA now for lab video with impact video. It varies ranges from 25 to 38, and according to the sequence, actually. Yeah, this four sequences are little bit simple. It has more PSNR compared to the complex sequences. Okay. This diagram shows the ABC. Actually, this is to find out the corresponding bit rate of ABC, which have similar quality with the lab video, MPEG-2, actually. Similar PSNR. Two binary, the corresponding bit rate of ABC. And we've tested some comparison. And here the anchor is a non-hierarchical B. So want to see how much the gain between the hierarchical B and non-hierarchical B. And we found that there is some 3.5 bit saving compared to non-hierarchical B. And we've increased the number of reference from 2 to 4, then there is some gain also. And we increased the search range from 32 to 64, there was 3% bit saving. In the case of HBC, the anchor is ABC, but significantly, the gain is around 34% bit saving. Wow. But as you know, the HBC is very superb, but at this moment, the HBC has not been finished, so maybe it could be a best solution for NLQ, even though real-time 3D service, but time is the matter. Okay, and then we also evaluate some complexity between ABC and HBC. Yeah, there is some 30.5 times complexity compared to ABC. Okay, I'm gonna skip this. Yeah. In the case of interview coding, we've tested two cases, like an impact video with the ABC and also MBC. Case one, to find out the gain of interview prediction compared to independent approach, actually. And case two is the MPEG-2 interview versus MBC. Ultimate goal is to assess the gain. Case one, we got 14% bit saving compared to independent coding. This is. And in case two, the MBC actually shows around 30% gain. Yeah, this figure shows that in here, MVC also simulate with the similar PSNR of lab video, MPEG-2, but there is also some gain. Yeah, in the case of MVC, the left video is encoded ABC. But in this combination, the left video is encoded MPEG-2 video. The PSNR actually is set quite similar, but there is also some gain. And from this result, we found that there might be any improvement in interview approach for MPEG-2 plus ABC. So it might be a deblocking filter for the reconstructed MPEG-2 video. And if we put some transformation of the reconstructed video in order to enhance the video up to the original enhancement video, then we can get more gain improvement. So I think the adaptive loop filter, which is used in HVC, could be a solution for this. And also, what we can found this study, at the moment, for independent coding, the impact video plus AVC is the best for NLT3D services. Because this is satisfied the backward compatibility, and actually it is timely available. And if we use the hierarchical B, then we can get more performance. And concerning the performance, HVC would be the best, but we have to wait maybe 2 years. And in the case of interview coding, as you know, this MPEG-2 plus MPEG-2 video plus AVC is superior to the independent coding. And also, MVC shows more gain versus MPEG-2 video plus AVC interviewed around 3.3 bit saving. Actually, from this study, now, as a future work, we are now focusing on here. Probably, if you put some pre-processing things between the MPEG-2 and then an ABC, there might be some significant gain. Thank you.
Thanks, Mr. Lee. We have time for a couple of questions. So I have one question. You said interview coding is better, but the bit rate saving is not very big, right?
Yeah, right.
So is that what is expected?
Yeah, sure, but the problem is the reconstructed video coded with MPEG-2 isn't good for being used as a reference video. But if we develop some sort of algorithm that can enhance the MPEG-2 reconstructed video, there might be some more gain.
Thank you. Let's thank the speaker again.